Good morning students, welcome to our class. I hope that you all are fine. So what did we learn children in previous class? In previous class we learnt about the lesson establishment of the British Empire in India, isn't it? In that lesson East India Company comes to East. How it comes? Okay, through the royal charter only, which is given by Queen Elizabeth I. And also what about mercantilism? And also Portuguese explorer Vasco da Gama invented sea route to India in 1498. By the time the Portuguese traders came to India, whose presence is there? Already Dutch people are there, and afterwards the French also is there, French traders, and last English people came. So these are the order: first Portuguese, and next the Dutch, and next the French, and last the English. Okay, these are the topics we discussed in previous class. Now armed traders, again next subtopic is armed traders. Okay, armed traders. So European traders, whomever the European traders are there, they formed their own companies to trade in India. So they formed some own companies to do trade in India. Because of that, they formed their own companies. So in order to the English traders formed the English East India Company. So the English people formed English East India Company, whereas from France formed the French East India Company. Okay, France people formed French East India Company, whereas English people formed English East India Company, so that they can trade with India. Both companies fight against each other for many years to capture the trade in India. See, these two companies, that means East English Company and French East India Company, both are fighting with each other so that they can capture the trade in India. Each effort made to drive the other away. Whatever they made those efforts, they drive another away. Another way, what is that? They brought armies from England. See here, they brought armies from England and France so that they help in their fight. Okay, because of that, these England people and France people brought their armies to India so that they can help them. The companies acquired land. These companies, European companies are there, no? Those companies acquired land in India. They get some land in India and built their own forts. Okay, they can build their own forts so that to wage battles against each other. The wealth that was accumulated trade that enabled England to develop industries and establish their dominance in the world. See how they are doing in India. When the wealth that is accumulated together, okay, to gather together by trade, so that they enabled England to develop industries and establish their dominance throughout the world. As long as Mughal Empire was strong, it had not begun possible for the European companies to establish their military power in India. See here children, when the Mughal Empire is strong, that time these European traders had not come to a place, okay, place, and also they are not establishing their military power in India. Why? Because in that time Mughal Emperor was very strong. Because of that, they had not come to our place. Like emperors are there in those times, Shah Jahan and Aurangzeb had fought and defeated European companies companies, number of times. See, emperors are there. In those times, Shah Jahan and last Mughal emperor is Aurangzeb. Both are fighting with these people and also defeated them also. Number of times they defeated these people. When the Mughal Empire broke up into small kingdoms, the companies found their chance to assert their power. After this Mughal Empire broke into small kingdoms. Okay, so for that these European companies, it's very easy to assert their power in India. The Mughal emperors as well as many rajas and nawabs began to realize the danger to let such traders to maintain armies, build forts, fight battles and establish their economic power in their kingdoms. See, later on these Mughal emperors many rajas and nawabs, they slowly realized why they are coming to our India. Okay, then it is dangerous. Those people come to our place and established their forts and also maintain armies, fight battles and established economic power to their kingdoms. Okay, slowly they realized. And next, in 1764, what happened here? Nawab Anwaruddin Khan, in 1764, Nawab is there here, Nawab Anwaruddin. Who is that? Anwaruddin Khan of Arcot. Anwaruddin Khan, Arcot, that means northern Tamil Nadu. It's located in northern Tamil Nadu, in this place. Kingdoms of India. See, it's growing. These European interference growing in the kingdoms of India. How it happened? The rulers also in return for their military help. See here, the Mughal rulers are there, no? Some rulers are there. What they are doing? They are gifted some, gifted the companies the large amount of money. Okay, these rulers are giving some amount of money to the companies so that in return they can help, military help. Okay, so that they return for their military help. So they are wanted to military help. Because of that they are giving some amount of money. This money helped the companies to increase their trade. Okay, because of that money they are increasing their trade in India. The companies also began to acquire small parts of kingdoms as gifts from the local rulers. Whomever the local rulers are there, no, those also given a gift to those companies. And also they are started acquiring some small lands also. These companies began to acquire, they are get some small parts of the kingdoms as their gifts from the local rulers. They are taking from the local rulers so small small parts of kingdoms. And they would collect the land tax from the villages and towns. See, these companies also collected land tax from villages and towns and used the money for their trading activities. So that money they are using for trading purpose only. They also used this money for maintaining and improving their army also. See here, for that money, that gifted money they have taken, no, from the rulers, that money they are using maintaining and improving their army only. And next, misuse of company's power. See here, how the misuse of company powers, that next subheading. They have to buy very low prices. that too the company only forced to them sell like that, like lower prices. And in this area, the companies try to squeeze revenue from the peasants beyond the reasonable limits. Here, some areas companies are there, no? Those companies also try to squeeze. Squeeze means the firmly they are forcing. They have to pay revenue like that. Squeeze revenue from the peasants. Okay, from the peasants they are squeezing. Firmly they are asking. Okay, firmly they are pressed to pay the revenue from the peasants beyond the reasonable limits. When the rulers protested against such practices, some rulers are there, no? They are protested these practices. The English fought against them. They even went to the extent of deploring kings. See here, if any ruler protested against such practices, what they have to do? They have to do remove from the their power. Okay, dethroning kings. That is some extended area will be there, no? That area, whomever the kings are there, they are removing from their power. Those companies are doing like that. If they fought against them, okay, they fought against them, or they protest against such practices, they have to remove from their power these kings. So that will happen. Next side heading is the English impose their rule. How the English resist? Okay, they take advantages to their rule. For trade, if they themselves rule the country, so they are gradually began to feel they have to what they have to, they could make use of India fully. Okay, they have to, themselves has to rule the entire country. They are gradually began to feel like that. Why? Because they wanted to rule themselves. Okay, nobody will come and rule the country. They have to themselves, they have to rule the country. They wanted like that. So they began removing the nawabs and rajas and started ruling themselves. So what they did, these European traders, these English people, what they did, they remove rajas and nawabs. Afterwards, they are started ruling the country. The Battle of Plassey, in an important event in Indian history in 1757 AD. One important event came to that time. Which year? 1757 AD. What happened here? The Battle of Plassey. Which one? The Battle of Plassey. Okay, in which year it started? 1757. When the Battle of Plassey is an important event in Indian history. In that time, what happened? The English defeated Siraj-ud-Daulah, the Nawab of Bengal. Siraj-ud-Daulah, who is that person? He was the Nawab of Bengal, and he was defeated by English people. And also, he has there established their rule in Bengal. Who's the Nawab of Bengal? Nawab of Bengal. Okay, Nawab of Bengal. Who's that? Siraj-ud-Daulah. Okay, who defeated him? The English people only defeated him in the Battle of Plassey. their rule in India. That means they established their rule over the Bengal. Okay. Afterwards, the East India Company forced the Nizams of Hyderabad also hand over the Northern Sarkars between 1765 to 1768 AD. Here, one more Nizams are there. Nizam of Hyderabad also. They are asked to hand over those. What? Northern Sarkar. What is that? Hand over the Northern Sarkars. Northern Sarkar. Nothing but here. Districts are there. Northern Sarkars means districts. See here. Krishna. విజయనగరం ప్రకాశం ప్రకాశం విశాఖపట్నం విశాఖపట్నం అండ్ గుంటూరు. సో సీ చిల్డ్రన్, దీస్ ఆర్ ద నాట్రల్ సర్కార్స్. ఓకే, ద నిజాం, ద నిజాం ఆఫ్ హైదరాబాద్ ఆల్సో హ్యాండ్ ఓవర్ ద Northern Sarkars. These are the Northern Sarkars in between 1765 AD to 1768 AD. In this period it happened. Okay, these Nizams of Hyderabad hand over these Northern Sarkars to English people. In return, English agreed to maintain an army contingent for the use of Nizam, so that they want their, in return what they did, English agreed to maintain an army. Contingent means chance. They wanted to give an army people the use of Nizam. Okay, for the use of Nizam. In fact, this army used more control the Nawabs rather than to help him. So these army people did not help the Nawabs. They are more control them, control over them. Okay, they didn't help them. These Nawabs, these army people more control the Nawabs only rather than help him. Next, Hyder Ali and Tipu Sultan of Mysore, the Maratha Sardar Mahadji Sindhia, Nana Padnivas and other fought against English. These are the people. Who are the people against English? And also their kingdoms were small and one by one they lost. Before they fought, they fight with English people. Who is that? Hyder Ali, Tipu Sultan of Mysore, Maratha Sardar Mahadji Sindhia, Nana Padnivas. These people fight against English. But their kingdoms are very small. Because of that, they lost one by one. And here, one more is there. Robert Clive, Warren Hastings and Lord Wellesley were generals who played an important role in British successes on the battlefield. See, these are the people success of British success on the battlefield. Who is that? Robert Clive, Warren Hastings, the Lord Wellesley were generals. So these people are generals in those times. Because of them, the British success on the battlefield. After slowly, large areas of India came under the direct rule of the English. See, after what happened? That all areas of India came under the direct rule of English. Okay? In many places, the Rajas and the Nawabs continued to rule, but they are under the sovereignty of English people only. They are ruling, but they are under control of sovereignty of the English people only. And English officials, here one more important thing children, and English officials are there, they are known as resident. Okay, they will call a resident also. They would be assigned to stay in the court of these kings or nawabs. See, these English officials are stay in their courts so that they could keep an eye on them. Okay, they could keep an eye on them. How they are running their kingdoms, how they are ruling their kingdoms. So these people keep an eye on them, how they are ruling. Okay, I hope that up to here understood properly. Remaining lesson we will discuss in next class. Write down homework, children. Now see here, children. I gave three questions. You have to write down. First question: which districts were called the Northern Circle? And when did the Battle of Plassey take place? And who did the English defeated in the Battle of Plassey? These three questions you have to write in your book. Thank you. Have a nice day. See you in the next class.